month of May was devoted to the softening up of the island fortress. At a few minutes before noon on Saturday, May 8, 1943, 33 American bombers made the first attack on Pantelleria, dropping about 43 tons of bombs on the airdrome. 30 minutes later, a second attack was made on the airdrome by 13 American fighters, each releasing half a ton of bombs. That was the beginning. Though this was predominantly an American operation, some Wellingtons took part in the night bombing. American manned Spitfires provided day fighter cover. Though ACAC was heavy at the beginning, there was no coordination among the guns and no altitude corrections because communications were soon bombed out. Enemy fighter opposition did not appear till much later. Day after day, in steady succession, came the heavy, medium, and light bombers, blasting the coastal guns, the fort, and the towns of Pantelleria. As the saturation approached its climax, whatever could fly took to the air. Fighter groups moved up to the Tunis and Bizerte area. P-40s ferried 500-pound bombs, and P-38s ferried one-ton bombs, and went back for more. Congestion was so great on the 10th of June and the morning of the 11th that aircraft had to wait their turn to get over the targets. The unprecedented weight of 5,153 U.S. tons of bombs were dropped in 11 days by 4,121 sorties of miscellaneous craft. In the last 24 hours, at least four times the weight of bombs were dropped on Pantelleria as were ever dropped in a comparable period on London at the height of the Blitz. To visualize the scope of this bombardment and the incredible pressure of traffic, one must add to the purely bombing sorties the thousands of fighter sorties flown as escort for bombers, on strafing missions, as armed patrol and interception missions. From the 8th of May to the close of the month, 718 U.S. tons of bombs were dropped, and 826 bomber sorties were flown, which included Lightnings, Bostons, Mitchells, Spitfires, Baltimores, and Flying Forts. June 1st was the turning point. From that day, the weight of bombs would be stepped up to where the enemy must surely be overwhelmed before the deadline. The curve of sorties and bomb loads rose so sharply that on June 10th, 1,108 sorties were flown and 1,477 tons of bombs dropped. At the deadline of 10:30, the previously planned amphibious operations took effect. Pantelleria was taken. It's satisfying to observe that many of these troops were veterans of the defeats at Dunkirk and Crete. ...1,121 prisoners fell to the Allies, of which only 89 were German. In surveying the extent of damage, it's interesting to note that only few casualties were reported. Air bombardment had kept both the garrison and civilian population under cover too much of the time. Allied occupation forces lost no time in repairing the airfield. 4 days after the Allied occupation of the island, on the morning and afternoon of June 15th, Stukas and ME-109s came to bomb Allied craft landing supplies in the harbor. As these pictures indicate, their strafing and bombing was ineffective as it was spirited. Thank you. afloat. And so, the tiny island was not only eliminated, but proved to be of help in the campaign for Sicily. Only a minor detail in the elaborate pattern of Allied conquest, yet the volcanic mountains of Pantelleria will always commemorate in military history the first surrender of a strong point to air power alone.